Hello everyone, welcome to the monthly budget spreadsheet demo. This tutorial is going to show you how to use this spreadsheet and how to get the best out of it. If you have not purchased this spreadsheet, I'll leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. We'll be working on this demo spreadsheet, but before I do that, I want to show you what it looks like when you actually receive it. When you receive the spreadsheet, it will look like this. And most of the items will be filled in, but you can delete the ones that you don't need to set it up in a way that works for you. When you open up the transactions tab, it would be blank and the dashboard would be blank. All right, so now we're back in the demo area. This has been completely filled out with some information so you can actually see how the spreadsheet works. Starting with the first tab, it's named list or setup. Basically, this is where you set up all of your information. You can type your currency by double clicking on the currency symbol here. So if you're using dollar, that would be fine. But if you're not using dollar, you can go ahead and delete that and type in whatever your currency symbol is. Once you do this, I will show you that it will change throughout the rest of the template. So as you can see here, everything changes to the euro symbol automatically. Next, we have the income tab. This is where you would type in all your income sources. So for example, if you receive two paychecks per month, you would type in the first paycheck and the second paychecks. If you receive one paycheck per month, you would type in just one paycheck. You can also type in other sources of income like bonuses, gifts, side jobs, etc. Basically, anything that brings in money into your budget, you would type it in here. Additionally, to keep track of the paydays, you can type in the day of the month that you expect to receive the money. Similarly, with the rest of the tables, you would categorize them into different categories. So your subscriptions, savings, the names of your saving accounts, your debts, your fixed bills. So specific things like electricity, water bill, rent, internet, things like that. And the last one is variable bills categories. So things like groceries, gas, dining out, these expenses can vary from week to week. When you get your template, it will come in pre-built with these examples to get rid of the excess ones that don't apply to you. All you need to do is select them and hit delete on your keyboard to get rid of the excess examples. All right, so we're moving on to the next tab, which is the transactions tab. And this is where you would input all of the transactions every single month. We'll start with the top part of this table because this is like a dashboard display area and it gives you some additional information related to the transactions that you are putting in. The top spending subcategories displays the top four categories that you are spending the most amount of money. The next area is a quick summary table. Most of the information from the transactions tab will be summarized in the dashboard tab. But if you are here and you want to quickly see how much you're spending per month, per category or subcategory, you can do that right here in the transactions tab. The first thing you need to do is to identify the month that you want to visualize how much you're spending. In this example, we're using October 2023. We can change it to something else like debts. And you can see for October 2023, the amount of debt we paid is about $1,050. You can do the same for subcategories by clicking on the drop-down box, selecting the subcategory. So for example, electricity for the month of October 2023, we paid $125. The next area in the transactions tab is your filters. Here you can filter by due date, category, and subcategory. Because this transactions tab can't capture as much as 1,000 transactions, it can become very long. So if you wanted to view a specific transaction or group of transactions, that's what you would use the filter feature for. And you can combine the different filters to summarize the information you want to see. For example, if I wanted to see all of the categories that were in my subscription, all I'll do is check off the other categories, or you can do clear and select the one you're interested in. Click done. Now it only shows me my subscriptions. If I wanted to further view the subcategory within that category and clear all, and I wanted to see only my meal kits, I select that, click OK. As you can see, it only displays the subscriptions to the meal kits. Another way to use this filter would be to tidy up your list. So let's say you wanted to get rid of one of the transactions that has been entered. One way to do it would be to delete it. But if you just wanted to hide it from view, but keep a record of it, you can use this checkbox column. So let me show you what I mean. So let's say I wanted to get rid of these three transactions that are in the subcategory of grocery. I would check the box All right, so now it's grayed out and it's out of my view, but it's still there. So now let's say I wanted to only see the rest of the categories that were not grayed out. So you can go back to the filter and click on the one that says done. Now true means it's checked and false means it's not checked. So we want to see the ones that are false. So we're going to uncheck true, click on okay. And now as you can see, those three transactions have disappeared from view. They're still there, meaning if we wanted to see them in the future, they're there. But that way we have a cleaner, shorter list of our transactions. So you can use this filter in many ways. One other way to use it would be to hide transactions from previous months. So you are only viewing the transactions that are in the current month. All right, so the next tab is the dashboard tab. And this is basically the tab that is more or less display only. What that means is that everything in this tab is automatically updated for you. You do not have to change anything with a few exceptions, and I will point them out shortly. So the first is the month, and this is the month that you want to display the information. Because all of the transactions in the transactions tab are captured from several different months and even several different years, the dashboard allows you to visualize only the transactions that apply to that month. So for this example, we are in October 2023. So let's say we wanted to see the transactions in November. So select the monthly dropdown and select November. And as you can see, the different amounts changed in the dashboard area as well as the graphs, because we don't have a lot of transactions entered in for the month of November. So let's go back to October so I can show you more of the features of the dashboard. All right, so the first is the expected versus actual. We have the expected amount, which is basically what you are budgeting at the beginning of the month, and the actual, which is what you spent at the end of the month. So you can compare and contrast your expected versus actual across all of your different categories. All right, so the next is the financial overview table, and this is where all of your categories are listed. You have your expected, your actual, and the difference. Part of the table that has the text in this light color, you're able to change. So basically, you're able to use this to plan your expenses for the month. You can plan how much you expect to get in each category, and then the actual amount is automatically updated from the transactions tab. The same applies to the rest of the table. So anything that has text in this light color, you're able to edit that every single month. Another thing I wanted to point out is this rollover category. You do have the option to add rollover income if that is part of how you budget per month. If you don't plan on using this feature, just leave it blank as is. If you want to use the rollover feature, go back to your list area and add rollover as part of your income. When you come back to your transactions area, you can add your rollover income. So let's say I wanted to add something for December 27th under income. Now it's an additional subcategory for income, and I can add that. Now let's change the date to something in October. So let's say October 1st. When we go back to the dashboard, you can see that that has been added into our actual rollover. So again, this is something that if you want to use, you have the option of using it. If you don't want to use it, just leave it blank. Anything that has a darker color is automatically pulled from the transactions tab. So with the income, you can see all of your income sources that has been pre-populated from your list and your transactions tab. You can budget at the beginning of the month and enter in all of your transactions during the month. And at the end of the month, it is populated here, and you can see the difference between what you budgeted and how much you expected to spend. At the beginning of the month, when you are creating your budget, you can change all of these to expected, and then you can type in your budget. So you can change all of these to when you're actually budgeting. Right now, you can see we only have $220 left to spend, and that's because we have inputted all of the expected numbers in financial overview table. Let's say we're expecting a little bit more than $5,000. I can show you how this graph changes. I'll change the income expected to $6,000. As you can see, the amount left to spend increases to $1,220. Let's say maybe I wanted to save a little bit more than $2,000. I would change this to maybe $2,500. And you can see everything automatically updates. So this way you can go back and forth based on what you're doing. If you are planning your budget for the month, switch them to. And if you are done and you want to see the actual expenses at the end of the month, switch all of them back to actual. That way you can visualize what you actually did compared to what you expected to do. All right, so that is the end of this tutorial. If you have any questions, go back to the instructions page. I have a step-by-step guide that explains more or less what I have covered in this tutorial. If you have quick questions, you can flip over to this tab and see if your questions can be answered here. I also have an FAQ section that has some of the frequently asked questions, so you can check that out as well. If you need to contact me, I have all of my contact information here, my website, my Etsy shop, as well as my social media links. Thank you so much for watching. If you do have any questions, feel free to leave them in the box below.